I'm all set.
Okay. So on a unanimous vote tonight, I mean, you guys are pretty clear in your decision.
Yes, I think so. I think particularly from the standpoint that the issue really at hand, it's a dual issue. There's a moral issue there in regards to what the officer did wrong. But on the other hand, there's a legal issue that we're obligated to address as a safety board. And the legal issue overshadows the moral issue to some degree from the standpoint, in my judgment, that there was no criminal action involved. And number two, with the retirement, the officer is off the force. He'll no longer be a policeman here in the town. The town, from a safety standpoint, all those things are covered.
Do you think it sends the message, though, to other officers, hey, you can mess up, and as long as you slide in that retirement letter or that resignation letter at the final hour?
Only if you have the years involved that would allow you to do that. But that's true in any department, whether it's here or whether it's someplace else. But otherwise, no. Not at all.
Do you think dollars and cents ruled the day? Because it would have been maybe an expensive legal fight, right?
It would have been, but under the circumstances, I think that safety board, I know from our discussions and so forth, we looked at the situation from the standpoint of how it was going to be best in serving the town and the safety of the town.
Because imagine what it would have cost the town had that young man killed someone.
Well, that's true. However, to me, those kinds of things, here again, there was no criminal activity involved. Had there been, it would have been a totally different matter. And you can be subjective about those things. The other side of that coin would be, well, you know, how often, and we'll be checking this, is how often do we check these tapes? I mean, maybe we need to be checking tapes more often and not randomly, but on a continuing basis. So there's a lot of questions that I think that come from this that will help us become even better in our law enforcement activity in the town. And I'm very comfortable that we have a great police force.
Isn't this a matter, though, where the safety board reversed itself entirely?
No, I'll tell you, that is not the case because of the fact that the safety board did not, when it first met, did not have all of the information that subsequently came out of that. The safety board did the right thing in moving forward because there was a misquote that the safety board fired Officer Moore, and that was not the case.
But that was not the case.
He was never fired because we don't have the authority to fire him in that situation. We proceeded, the safety board at that time, with the information they had, agreed to move forward. And that's where the misquotes came about. And those were misquotes in the paper that, in my judgment, someone didn't do their job in reporting.
But you voted to move forward with what? Termination.
We voted to move forward with a hearing.
To terminate.
We voted to move forward to have the hearing to discuss termination and or retirement. Whatever the case may be, we were going to hear it in a hearing. We would hear from both sides. And that had not taken place. And then subsequently, in light of the fact that he had the time and grade, he had the ability to retire. There was no criminal, to our knowledge, there was no criminal intent here, or no criminal activity that took place. We chose to take this route.
Anything else that you want to add that we haven't thought to ask?
I can't think of it offhand. I mean, I think that we covered it very thoroughly, and we have analyzed all of the information that came to us, and I think we've made the right conclusion.
You're comfortable with
your
decision?
I'm very comfortable with the decision.
Okay. Thank you.
Hey, thank you.